Yes, students. So one question which we really had maybe a doubt in or in our attempt here in our test, that was regarding speech writing. Yes, can you tell me yourself what do you think that why you lost marks over there? How can you make your speech even better? Even notice for that matter. So today I'm just going to review the question paper with you all. And then we'll continue again with the chapter that we had begun. So do you remember which chapter we have been discussing? The ailing planet. Do you remember it? Yes? Do you remember? Yes, so what about speech writing? It is a form of writing which is very different from your report or an article writing, because you're not only expressing your views, you are convincing people with your views. You're making, you know, like you're putting your views across to others and yes, telling them why you feel that you are right. Okay. And you want the, you know, audience also to agree with you. So, right, and of course, here in a speech, when we discuss any topic, we generally discuss about the pros and the cons, the positives and the negatives. That is what makes it different from a debate. Okay, so when we write a speech, what are the things that I look for? I do look for, yes, the appropriate content. Like it was a simple speech that you had to write about yoga. Okay. So, like, of course, anybody can write a paragraph on yoga. And many of you ended up doing that only. It was a paragraph within a speech. So you had introduction, you had an ending, but in between it was more of a paragraph, right? Or maybe an article about it. So what is the use or why should we practice yoga? Right? Yes, so you can say it is an ancient art. Everybody told about that, the various asanas many of you had discussed. But why should we? What makes it better than any other form of exercise? Or why should we benefit from that? Or why should we do this form of exercise, right? So you have to, like, you know, when you are like, look at how am I talking to you, or when you have your lectures, or when you have a meeting or an assembly, right? So how that interaction takes place, right? Okay, of course, you're not going to ask again, are you listening, or right? You can just definitely ask that, my dear friends, I hope you will agree with me when I say that yoga has multiple benefits and we all need to start practicing yoga in our daily lives. And of course, yes, it is not necessary that we have to rush towards the gym here for our fitness. So, right, it is, you can say maybe a long-term process, but its benefits are also more lasting than other exercises that we attempt to do. Right? So yes, and how, of course, the precautions that you need to take, that in case you have some medical ailment, you need to discuss with your doctor first, you have to be cautious. So some asanas you can't perform if you have some kind of problem, like maybe you're talking about, you have your joint pains or other issues that you've had. But the best is, yes, you can do it there in the comfort of your home. So, right. So please you have to start with your introduction, your name, your class, and I am, not I is. Very wrong, very wrong, very incorrect. Okay. And you are there talking to the audience. What is it that you are discussing about? Okay. Right. Talk about the benefits. Then yes, how you can practice it. I don't think so. There are any disadvantages. Yes, only disadvantages would be if you do it wrong, right? So your posture is incorrect. You might end up pulling a muscle. You might end up causing a bit of a problem for yourself. These are things that you have to keep in mind, okay? And of course, we end with a polite thank you for being a patient listener. Well, I'll be giving you more writing skills in this regard. I'll be giving you one or two more speeches so that you can practice it. Then regarding a notice writing, it seems as if you have forgotten that notice writing presentation is very, very important, okay? Right. So your presentation had to be there. You had to talk about it was about the summer camp. Right. So some of you just put the heading camp coaching. What? your heading here, the title has to be informative. It has to be informative. You are talking about the purpose of writing that. So make a box, especially highlight it. Your date, your venue, your time, what kind of activities, you're charging a nominal fee, right? All these things, any special, you know, like a feature about these camps. So one or two students had added, you know, like, yes, those who are participating in this, you'll get chances to be selected for our school team and even participating in maybe zonal activities or district level activities. So that is there, you know, learn to add more information. It's just a question and you pick up the information from there and you put it in a box and your answer is ready. No, you need to add more. That is what is going to make your answer better. What is going to make your answer different? Yes. So hope you people are going to attempt your answers in a better way. Okay. Right. So do you remember which chapter we were discussing before the exams or before your break? We had started with the ailing planet. What is the chapter about? What is it about? Let me give a reminder to the students also to join the class. I think so. Still think that today is a off day. Okay. Now, let me share this video with you all. Is this visible? Can you see the screen? Yes, give me a yes or no, please. Is it visible? Okay. This is just a simple video which shows about the beauty of our earth and how we have managed to destroy it. What are the things that we need to remember? That we are not the sole inhabitants of this planet. There are so many species inhabiting it along with us. So we need to keep this in mind that we are here, not the sole occupants. Look at this beautiful diversity of this life, right? And I think so they contribute more to the planet than we do. What has man done since his arrival on the earth? So just look at this video and we'll appreciate the beauty of our planet. And then we'll really understand the importance of why we need to save it. Of course, there's no doubt about it why we need to save it. See how we are there, right? As I have discussed, how we are disturbing all these ecosystems. Look at it, development. Is it actually development? Is it? What are the consequences of this development? How is it affecting our planet? And when we say that our planet is ailing, when we say that our planet is ailing, what does it mean? It means that it's not well. We need to take care of it. So we are exploiting it. This is their a very precarious situation. We've gone through it. We've gone through it. Even then, we are not taking any action. Planet doesn't need us, we need the planet. Yes? So if we start here immediately taking action, right? I think so we can do a lot to save it. So we have to start acting. It's a beautiful planet that we have. Beautiful planet. We need to save it. Each one of us, young, old, and it is this biodiversity that keeps our planet alive, that adds to the beauty of the planet. So after seeing this video, I really want you to appreciate this beautiful planet that we are inhabiting. Okay, right? So can we continue with the chapter now? Yes, we have here. Wait. I don't know, there's a so we had started the discussion of this chapter, that was the ailing planet, and what have we read about in it? That was the role of man and how he has destroyed the planet, and yes, has damaged it to such an extent that the earth is now showing signs of being in a diseased state. It's not well. And how is the earth showing that, right? All the systems there, they are in a very terrible condition, right? And we have to change our approach. We have to change the way we look at the earth, right? And we have to realize that the planet, it does not belong to any one of us. It belongs to all of us. And individually, we have to take care. We have to make sure that we are putting in right efforts to make our planet come out of this, sad state it is in. And what has been discussed? We discussed about the sustainable development, that is, the resources should be used wisely and judiciously in a proper manner. So the resources are also there for the future generations, right? But what is man doing? He's using everything recklessly, as I've shown you in the video also. The oxygen there, we're talking about the scarcity of water. How in the name of development and urbanization, forests are being cut, and all the ecosystem is being disturbed. And so many examples we have, so many instances happening, but even then we do not realize. And what is most important to realize, along with us, we have other animals. We have co-inhabitants of this planet, and they have every right to be on this earth as much as we do. Many of, the species that are there, we have brought them to the verge of extinction. Many have become extinct. Many species we are not even aware of, right? We're not even aware of that. And they are there on the verge of extinction. And see, so much beautiful life we have, diversity over there on this planet, which we need to preserve, which we need to take care of, okay? And what is there? We had read about a zoo at Lusaka. How does it tell that man is the most dangerous animal? How does it tell that man is the most dangerous animal? So there's a mirror over there in a cage, and on top of it, it is written the world's most dangerous animal. Do you remember that? Yes. Do you remember that? And we realize that we are there, the most dangerous, and how much harm we have done to this planet, okay? Right. Then, of course, we had discussed it, how the Earth has four biological systems. What are they? Fisheries, forests, grasslands, and croplands. This is the basis on which the global economic system rests, right? And this is on which our whole earth depends. And if one of them collapses, it is going to cause a great detrimental or a serious effect on the condition of the earth. So it is very, very important that we write, act in time, act wisely and judiciously. Fisheries, how are we destroying the fisheries? How do you think we are destroying the fisheries? Can I get an answer? How are we destroying them? Yes, overfishing, exploitation, and we do not stop fishing. We do not give it time to replenish itself and constantly fishing, so we're like, man is there now very protein conscious and all. And as a result, overfishing, it has put a burden on these limit resources, right? So we need time for them to replenish. And of course, what are the oil spills and the effluents and the discharges, how they are harming the water bodies. So all these things here, we are really so bad. We're not taking care of our planet at all. What about forests? How have we harmed the forests? How have we harmed the forest? Deforestation. Yes. And of course, here it is. Deforestation is there. We talk about, we need for development. Otherwise, also the forests are there, the habitat of so many species. Right? So we destroy that. We are making them homeless. Let us think about the other species also for a change. Let us not be so selfish. Right? And then, of course, the forests are being destroyed for firewood. They need that. And people are there, so we're cutting down of the trees for that. Okay? Then what about the grasslands? What about the grasslands? How are we harming that? So overgrazing, once again. Overgrazing, the cattle there, the animals there, overgrazing of the grasslands. As a result, what happens? Soil erosion happens, right? So these problems are there. So we need to replenish that also. Croplands, we want more and more crops in lesser time. As a result, what are we doing? We're adding more and more fertilizers. We're adding more and more chemicals and pesticides to the soil. And in a way, we are reaping that also. We're getting it back also, isn't it? Look at the health issues that we have because of the chemicals entering our system, right? So we need to take care of that. How can that be stopped? Let us leave the land maybe. We can leave it fallow for some time without cultivating, without growing, and let it regain its productivity. But no, we are in such a hurry. We think about here, there are so many mouths to feed and we want more and more profits. Okay, right? Yes, and of course, here it is rightly said, what are the forests? The powerhouse of evolution. It is there, so many species which are there. And if we destroy a forest, what is going to happen? We are going to lose their habit, or rather they are going to lose their habitat. Where are they going to go? How will they survive? They're going to come towards the cities. What happens when they stray, or you can say they come towards the cities? We chase them away, kill them. So it is, we are there so terrible, right? So it is better that we take care of our forests so that we have, you can say, this beautiful, diverse fauna, okay? Now let's start our reading. I think so we had reached here. Now it has been well said that forests precede mankind. Deserts follow. Forests come, then man comes. And then what happens? Deserts. Who creates the deserts? Man creates the desert. What does he do to the forest? He destroys them all. The world's ancient patrimony of tropical forests is now eroding at the rate of 40 to 50 million acres a year. And the growing use of dung for burning deprives the soil of an important natural fertilizer. So the cow dung, which adds to the soil, even nowadays that is also used as a fuel, right? The World Bank estimates that a five-fold increase in the rate of forest planting is needed to cope with the expected fuel wood demand in the year 2000. So this is, we're talking about 2000, now it's 21. Would you think the situation has become better or the situation has become worse? right? Of course, we read about the fires in the tropical forests, right? We talk about deforestation, landslides, all this condition here, scarcity of water, right? The air quality deteriorating. Do you think, are we better off or are we worse off? Even though we are more aware. So even if we are making efforts, are they enough? They have to be multiplied many times if we want our planet to be safe. James Speth, the president of the World Resources Institute, said the other day, we were saying that we are losing the forest at an acre a second, but it is much closer to an acre and a half to a second, right? So yeah, statistics may not be correct. Now, what is our approach towards the forests and the wildlife? How concerned are we? We're talking about the world. What about our country? What are we doing for it? Article 48A of the Constitution of India provides that the state shall endeavor to protect and improve the environment and to safeguard the forests and wildlife of the country. So it is the responsibility of the state to safeguard the forest, to safeguard the wildlife. You go on the national highway, you travel there, what do you see? Trees being cut, roads being widened. Are we planting more trees? Are we taking care that we need to, you know, like we need the green cover, right? So we are there. What are we making this whole place? We're making it a concrete jungle. And of course, we have noticed that how the temperatures are rising, right? But what causes endless anguish is the fact that laws are never respected nor enforced in India. Do you agree with this? Why do we have to say that laws are never respected nor enforced in India? Any law that we take, how do we treat it? We are so casual about it. And then when it comes to environment and forests and wildlife, we are least bothered. So we have to be very, very concerned about our wildlife, right? It is our responsibility to take care of it. Now, what about other laws? Here it is about the environment and the wildlife. For instance, the Constitution says that casteism, untouchability, and bonded labor shall be abolished. But they flourish shamelessly even after 40 years of the operation of the Constitution. Now, it's more than that. More than that. And even now, we do hear about, yes, we hear about child labor, we hear about caste discrimination. So, of course, even the Constitution has called it wrong, but we still have people there practicing it. That means, what is our opinion about laws? Do we enforce them? Do we follow them? No, we don't. What about the traffic rules? Do you follow them? What about rules that are made to keep us safe during the pandemic? How cautious are we? No, and then of course, when things become terrible, then we decide or think about whom we have to blame. When in the first place, we were the ones who were careless and casual, right? So everything here, we have to own up responsibility. Let us own up responsibility that we need to take care of our earth. A recent report of a Parliament's Estimates Committee has highlighted the near catastrophic depletion of India's forest of the last four decades. Catastrophe, disastrous. India, according to reliable data, is losing its forest at the rate of 3.7 million acres a year. It's an alarming amount. Large areas officially designated as forest land are already virtually treeless. The actual loss of forest is estimated to be 8 times the rate indicated by government statistics. A 3-year study using satellites and aerial photography conducted by the United Nations was that the environment has deteriorated so badly that it is critical in many of the 88 countries investigated. Do you think we are among them? Definitely we are among them. What else is there adding to our problem? There can be no doubt that the growth of world population is one of the strongest factors distorting the future of the human society. It took mankind more than a million years to reach the first billion. We took a million years to reach the first billion. But then after that, boom, what happened? That was the world population around the year 1800. By the year 1900, a second billion was added. And the 20th century has added another 3.7, so three times what was added here between 1800 to 1900. And when population is more, the problems are going to be more. The present world population is estimated at 5.7 million. Every 4 days, the world population increases by 1 million.